From WXII 12 News, this is Breaking News.
Breaking news this afternoon, a person in North Carolina has the new strain of the coronavirus.
Governor Roy Cooper and his coronavirus task force are holding a press conference about the state's first presumptively positive case. Let's take a listen in now.
It's important to know that the health and safety of North Carolinians is our top priority. The task force that I appointed and our public health experts have been working around the clock to ensure we are prepared. Our state lab has been testing for the new coronavirus, and today we have confirmed our first presumptive positive results for the new coronavirus in North Carolina. The person from Wake County, North Carolina, traveled to the state of Washington and was exposed at a long-term care facility where there is a current outbreak of the new coronavirus. Local health department officials are working to identify who else may have been exposed to help contain the spreading. The person is doing well and is in isolation at home. We've been preparing for this, and we do expect to see more cases in North Carolina. We are working closely with local health departments, healthcare providers, and others to quickly identify and respond to new cases. Yesterday, I was part of a call that included other governors as we were updated on federal actions. We're providing resources to and hosting regular calls with local health providers and partners. There are also important and common sense steps that you can take to protect yourself and your families. The simplest steps are the most important. Wash your hands often and avoid touching your face as much as you can. Cover your mouth and nose when you cough or sneeze. Clean and disinfect surfaces frequently. Stay home if you're sick and have a plan in case you need to miss work. People who have concerns about this new virus should contact their local health departments. I encourage businesses and employers to review policies for remote working and make sure workers aren't being encouraged to come to work when they're sick. Know how to reach your local health department in case you have questions. The same goes for schools and childcare centers. Finally, I'll say there is a lot of bad information out there. Make sure you are getting information from reliable sources. You can visit our North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services website. It's ncdhhs.gov/coronavirus for updates. I know people are worried about this virus, and I want to assure you that the state of North Carolina is prepared. Our most important work is keeping people healthy and safe. I'm joined today by the Secretary of the North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services, Dr. Mandy Cohen, our State Public Health Director, Dr. Elizabeth Tilson, our Secretary of Department of Public Safety, Secretary Eric Hooks, Mike Sprayberry, our Emergency Director of Emergency Management, and we have with us the Public Health Director of Wake County, Chris Kippis, with us today. I'm first going to recognize Secretary Cohen for a few remarks, and then all of us will be ready to take your questions. Secretary Cohen.
Thank you, Governor. Good afternoon. I'm Mandy Cohen. I'm the Secretary of Health and Human Services for North Carolina. Just to give you a little more information about how we have been preparing and continue to prepare to respond to COVID-19 or the new coronavirus. First, our public health team, in coordination with emergency management, have proactively stood up our preparation work starting back in January. We put together an aggressive containment strategy of rapidly identifying suspected cases, testing them, and doing any contact tracing. Yesterday, our state lab began testing cases, which means we can get results faster and respond faster. And we continue to monitor returning travelers through our local health departments to prevent the spread. We've also, as of last month, the governor mentioned we stood up and formalized our work in our new novel coronavirus task force. And thank you to Dr. Tilson and to Mike Sprayberry for chairing that task force. We continue to collaborate daily, sometimes talking multiple times a day with our federal, state, and local partners. Our teams at the Department of Health and Human Services and Public Safety are developing detailed response plan for a range of the scenarios as we move forward. We have been continuing to prepare with our healthcare providers and facilities to streamline and standardize response activities, including having regular calls and mobilizing resources. And as you know, we've been sharing guidance on how folks can think about proactively preparing for themselves. Guidance for healthcare workers, guidance for childcare, employers, schools, colleges, universities, again, all on the website the governor mentioned. And today, because we know that information and making sure you have accurate information is particularly important, we've activated the Joint Information Center to make sure we are able to get you timely information. And again, let me give you the website for the most timely information about COVID-19 or the new coronavirus. That's ncdhhs.gov/coronavirus. And with that, I'll turn it back to the governor and take your questions. Thank you.
Okay, we'll take your questions. Yes, sir.
Hi, it's Gary Robertson, Associated Press. Governor, can you give us any more information about where in Wake County this person is, and the fact that this person came from Washington would lead me to believe that it came back here through an airline or something like that. Is there any concern about that? If true, is there any concerns about the people on that flight?
There is investigation going on with this particular person, but I'm going to turn it over to one of our health authorities to talk about that.
Sure, I'll start. So the person is someone in Wake County. They did travel back from the state of Washington. They did return from state of Washington on a flight. And so we are doing and starting that work now to trace folks' immediate contacts that they would have had. And that includes going back to making sure folks on that flight are made aware. So that work is just beginning. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Governor. I know that you said that the victim is in isolation. I also understand that Wake County Hospital has been a designated facility for our region. So is that individual in isolation at Wake Med or at their residence?
They're in isolation at their residence.
And how long do you anticipate that they could be there?
Turn that over. Dr. Tilson.
Thank you for that question. There are criteria for releasing people from isolation, and that means that they no longer have symptoms and they've been tested negative 24 hours apart. So have to have two negative tests 24 hours apart and no symptoms. Those would be the criteria for ending isolation.
Explain what happens from here on out. Are there check-ins on a daily basis? What happens?
Yeah, maybe I can turn it over to our Wake County Public Health Director, who can really talk about the monitoring of the contacts.
Thank you and good afternoon. So the question was what kind of happens here with respect to local health departments maintaining contact with the individual. We actually touch base with them at least twice a day and ask them how they're feeling. They are responsible for monitoring their own temperature. So we ask very specific pieces of information to help us understand their health.
So those are details that we're not going through at this point. So we're going through all of those details in terms of who have they been in contact with and working through that now.
Can you just give the name of the Wake County Health Director, please?
Yes, it's Chris Kippes, K-I-P-P-E-S, Chris, C-H-R-I-S.
Governor,
yes.
I'm serious. So what would you say to Wake County residents right now, those in the Triangle immediate area, about what they need to know, what they can do? Obviously, North Carolina is now just the second state in the country. So what can you tell residents?
And I think people should take extra care to make sure they wash their hands frequently. And, you know, it's very easy to be in contact with a lot of people and then touch your face, your eyes, your nose. Try not to do that. Try to make sure that your hands are clean before you put them on your face, and to try to disinfect surfaces around the home. I think it's important to take extra care now. You want to do this anyway, because we're not far from the peak of flu season, and 24 North Carolinians died last week of the flu. And so we want to make sure that people cover their mouth and their nose when they cough or sneeze. And I think you just take it on a case-by-case basis. I mean, we're not telling people to change their life in any way at this point. We're just telling them to be more careful and to pay attention when you yourself or a member of your family is sick. Stay home, don't go out, don't be around other people.
You mentioned earlier there's a lot of bad information out there. Can you go over some of the specifics of what you're seeing that you'd like to clear up for people?
I really don't want to reinforce the bad things that are out there. I don't know if either of you guys would have anything. Go ahead, Dr.
Why don't we share some good information rather than reinforcing some of the bad? And I'll turn it over to Dr. Hilson to maybe go through a bit of what this virus is in terms of a coronavirus, and a bit of what we're learning new. I will say that there is a lot we are learning and know about it, but it is still a new situation, and so there is new things that we're learning every day.
So what we do know, and again, we are continuing to learn, and we will update you if things that we know changes. But going forward, one is that coronaviruses, it's a family of viruses. There are actually 7 viruses that affect humans. 4 circulate regularly. And then there's been 3 that, and those 4 circulate regularly and tend to cause very mild illness. There's been 3 that circulate that are more rare, that can cause more severe illnesses. And so if you remember in the past, there was SARS and MERS, and then this COVID-19 is a new rare one as well. What we are finding is that for this COVID-19, the vast majority of people, more than 80%, have mild symptoms. And then less than 20% would have some more severe symptoms. What we're finding is that at most, the mortality rate might be about 1.4%, meaning 98.6% of people will get through it. And we anticipate that mortality rate might actually be coming down the more we learn about the virus and more people that have maybe very mild symptoms. We also know that to this point, it seems that older people with underlying health conditions seem to be at higher risk. And what we also are seeing, that in general, children seem to fare very well, and only about 1% of the cases have been identified in children and seem to fare very well. So those are some of that we know about this virus and how it's affecting people.
So I know you all said that the person flew to North Carolina. Can you share which airport, and also when did you first suspect or identify this individual?
So we're not releasing any additional details. Obviously, they flew back from Washington State. Otherwise, they'd still be in transit. But other than that, those details we are not releasing at this time. We want to make sure that we're doing good contract tracing in coordination with the team in Wake County, and go from there. Thank you.
One more question.
Yes.
I saw here that the sample has been sent to the CDC for further testing and confirmation. Do you have a timetable on when you might hear back or what that might look like?
Yes. So the lab, the state lab in North Carolina did do this test and it came back positive, and it is a presumptive positive because it is only the second day in which our lab is doing that testing. And so for a period of time, we will do confirmatory tests with the CDC. So those samples are on their way to the CDC for confirmation. We've been in about a 24-hour turnaround time for confirmation, though that changes depending on the queue in Atlanta. That's one of the reasons why we're glad that we're increasing our testing capacity here in North Carolina.
And being that you said that you reached out to some of the other individuals who were in close contact with that specific person, have you sent any additional testing or samples up?
So we have been identifying potential cases since late January, all of which have been negative to date. This is our first positive, and we will continue, I'm sure, to see additional cases of folks who maybe had travel, had contact with someone who may have COVID-19, and we'll continue to test them as we move forward.
Okay, one thing we want to do is to thank all of our healthcare professionals who work so hard every day and work through these kinds of situations. We are grateful for all of them, and we will be back when we have more information for you. I want to also introduce Lee Williamson, who is doing our sign language interpretation today. Thank you very much.